Time to talk about some tax news. A Manhattan judge delivered some bad news to taxpayers in certain states yesterday, rejecting a challenge to Trump's tax overhaul from states that said that the overhaul would disproportionately affect blue states. And here to explain more is Alexis Keenan. Alexis, thanks for coming on.
You're welcome.
So, yeah, how do we get into this here? I mean, what does it mean for taxpayers? And what's the political breakdown here? Because I think it's not necessarily what it looks like when you see, okay, this Trump tax overhaul, and then it will affect blue states disproportionately. Can we sort of explain that?
Okay, so this lawsuit was brought last year against the IRS, and it was brought by New York, New Jersey, Maryland, and Connecticut. Those are all high tax states, high income tax states, as well as expensive places to live, meaning high property taxes. So these states said that the cap, this $10,000 cap that was put into place on those SALT taxes by President Trump in December 2017 and had its first effective tax year in 2018 is unconstitutional, and it unfairly subjects these blue-leaning states to have to coerce them to lower their taxes. So the states are upset about this. However, the judge yesterday, a federal judge appointed by President Obama, said, wow. No. The federal government has wide latitude to apply these income taxes, and states can adjust as they wish, and they have their sovereign ability to do that.
Wow. Well, and this is very interesting because, you know, when you value a home in these states, you're not just looking at the purchase price, but you're also looking at the taxes. And so
Absolutely.
Almost overnight, all these taxes effectively went up, which you could argue decreased the value of the home, or at least it should have.
You could, and that's one of their arguments, absolutely.
Look at 2018 on this chart. I mean,
and the other thing I wanted to point out is, Alexis, you and I were talking earlier about how these tax cuts, the whole bill expires in a few years. So, I mean, you have people moving out of New York and New Jersey to lower tax states because of this SALT deduction, but eventually things will revert back to how they were before the bill in a few years.
They will. So the sunset for this implementation is 2025. So after 2025, for the 2026 tax year, supposedly taxpayers will no longer be subjected to this, but that doesn't mean that another president or another Congress won't decide otherwise, especially now that all this money is flowing into the federal coffers. Mm-hmm.
Were the states that brought this challenge saying overtly that it was a political situation?
Absolutely, they were. Yeah. Yes, they said that this was targeted by the Trump administration at blue states. However, I have to note that other states like Illinois have not joined in, high tax states. California did not join in that lawsuit. Some states have also tried some other avenues to try, they call them workarounds, to say, okay, well, these additional taxes, that deductions that you cannot now claim, you can try to push those into a charitable donation type of structure. That hasn't worked either. The IRS doesn't like that. They like this money that's coming in. Yes, challenges probably still to come. This is at the district court level. It can still be appealed. So we will wait for that.
All right, we'll wait. No, the IRS doesn't love when you fudge things.
Yeah.
Surprise, surprise.
Yeah.
Alexis, thanks so much.
You're welcome.